सर वन ऑफ द मेन रिकमेंडेशंस ऑफ द प्रेस कमीशन हैज बीन द एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ अ प्रेस काउंसिल कंसिस्टिंग प्रीडोमिनेंटली ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री विच शुड अंडरटेक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फॉर रेगुलेशन ऑफ द प्रेस इन जनरल. द कमीशन फाउंड इन द कोर्स ऑफ द इंक्वायरी दैट जर्नलिस्ट हैड नॉट कम आउट टू कंडेमन इन दियर रेटिंग्स द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ ऑब्जेक्शनेबल एंड वाट इज नोन समटाइम्स एज द एलो प्रेस. This is generally speaking not only for maintaining the standards of journalism but also for public criticism. Since this is a matter of serious consequence, the commission posed the question to most journalists and journalistic institutions who appeared before them to give evidence. The consensus of opinion was that it would be better if there is a body formed predominantly of journalists to judge and direct journalists in maintaining ethical standards in the matter of journalism. The commission therefore came to the conclusion that the best way of maintaining professional standards in journalism would be to bring into existence a body of people principally connected with the industry whose responsibility it would be to arbitrate on doubtful points and to censor anyone guilty of infraction of the code. I would like to emphasize the word censor. The object before the press commission was the formation of a body which will not deliver a judicial judgment but would point out the culprit and condemn him morally and nothing more. For that he is judged guilty at the bar of moral public opinion. The principal functions of the council as proposed by the press commission would be to help newspapers to maintain their independence, to evolve and maintain standards of journalistic ethics, to keep under review developments tending towards monopoly and to promote research and provide common service to the press. These are the main objectives that have been proposed by the press commission. The function of the council given in clause 12 of this bill is not only in line with the recommendations of the commission but also broadly takes up those which are existing in the General Council of Press in the United Kingdom. The emphasis, no doubt, is on the liberty of the press, and the council, when formed, will no doubt recommend lines on which that freedom can be preserved. The council would be an autonomous body in the discharge of its functions and regulate its procedure. Now the main points as far as the formation of the council is concerned are two, one is the chairman and the other is the composition of the council. The commission have recommended that the chairman should be an eminent person who should be generally a judge of a high court and should be nominated by the Chief Justice of India. We have considered this question very carefully, and in considering it, we have also been guided to some extent by the debate on the Press Commission's report that took place here during the last session. We have felt that it would be unnecessarily restricting the choice in searching for a very suitable chairman. If we put it down on the statute book that the chairman shall always be a high court judge, no doubt the council will be armed with certain powers which can be considered to be judicial, but it has to be remembered that the objective or the purpose behind giving these powers is not a judicial inquiry but the enforcement of attendance of witnesses and certain other matters. For example, in the United Kingdom, where a voluntary council has been working, it has been found that the council is not able to make witnesses come before it, and cases have not been wanting where very prominent witnesses have contemptuously disregarded the request of the council to appear before them, and it is in that light that the Press Commission strongly recommended that not only there should be a statutory council, but also the council should have certain powers to enforce witnesses to come before it. My point is that it will not at all be helping the work of the council if we restrict the choice of the chairman to high court judges. We have to remember what the object is before the Press Council. The Press Council is not a judicial body. It is also not a body for investigation. It is a body which has to observe carefully the trends in the press, not purely from a judicial angle, but mainly from the moral and public angle, and decide on balance as to whether a particular paper or the writings in a particular paper are such as not come up to the journalistic ethics that have been laid down. Now, that is not really speaking a judicial purpose, and no doubt it is possible to have very eminent high court judges and chief justices, but it would be, in our opinion, doing injustice to the journalistic profession if we lay down for all time that only a high court judge can be the chairman.